5, 6, 7, 8.
Come on, babe, why don't we paint the house?
Assistant Director of Ballet Western Reserve, and my speech is a little longer because they said they need time to change into their point shoes for the last number, so bear with me. I came back to Ballet Western Reserve last April during an important transition period, and it has been a year and 1 month of moving forward with this important dance education organization. What a year it has been at Ballet Western Reserve. Ballet Western Reserve is back on the map, and we have reclaimed our position and visible presence as an innovator of dance and the arts in the Mahoning Valley. Collaborations, appearances, and performances, we've done it all this year. Youngstown has defined itself as a proud and culturally significant community, and this year, Ballet Western Reserve, in collaboration with community organizations and cultural institutions, became a leader in this program. People around town know who we are and what we're all about. Please take the time to look at your program and see what we've accomplished this year. It is quite impressive. Collaborations with Opera Western Reserve, Victorian Players, YSU, among others. We've lent our support in appearances at benefits, fundraisers, and causes, such as the Autism Society of Mahoning Valley, the Alzheimer's Association of East Ohio Area, and WFMJ's Feed Our Valley. Last night, we closed a beautiful production of Fiddler on the Roof, produced by the Youngstown Playhouse in conjunction with BWR. Austin, Caroline, Emilia, Augie, Lulu, Megan, Hunter, and Gracie danced and sang and act with Youngstown's finest actors and brought our name to the forefront of the theater community. Like our Nutcracker, if you missed this show, you missed something quite special and important. In frequent conversation with Anita Lynn, Ballet Western Reserve's illustrious director for much of its existence, she's in agreement and support of our efforts to get ourselves back into the community. And that brings me to the Youngstown Nutcracker, a Youngstown Nutcracker. This year's production was an all-encompassing artistic achievement for Ballet Western Reserve. And next year's production will provide more opportunities for our dancers and will be even more spectacular. I'd like to thank Ballet Western Reserve and all of you out there for the great opportunity of working with a school and company that has not only a rich history, but also much promise and potential. And it is that potential that I find in your daughters and sons. I see Ballet Western Reserve as inclusive, not exclusive. If you want to pursue a career in dance, you should be here. Our instructors are trained, certified, and graduates of universities and dance training programs. If you want to dance recreationally, we offer many styles of dance, not just ballet, as you saw today, but also tap, modern, hip-hop, and master classes in other styles, such as Afro-Caribbean and Broadway musical theater. If you want to learn to dance correctly with technique, alignment, and artistic style, you should be here. As the children grow so quickly, it is important that we allow them to savor those precious years as children. As you can see, we let them dance in a manner that is appropriate to their age. While it has been a treat to choreograph, coach, and create works on the older dancers, I've had the opportunity to work with many of the younger children. Our Youngstown Nutcracker utilized those talents and allowed them to dance real dances just like the big kids. Whether it's boundless energy of Maggie or the inquisitiveness of Anastasia, each child is unique, different, and has their own special personality. And I will say, I also enjoy the assistance with my coffee and conversations with little Danica. As parents and supporters, your involvement is crucial to Ballet Western Reserve. I've heard the suggestions and opinions many of you have expressed over the course of the year. Please realize that I'm approachable, so you know if you have something, a concern or a suggestion, please come to me. Communication is the key to our success. The Parents Guild, headed by Diane Stahl, has organized in a way that will support our efforts. Christine Paverka headed the Frosted Tutu thing that we had a while back, the Frosted Tutu Party. Rick and Anna A. transformed our second floor space for building art. Many individuals have come forward to volunteer their assistance with whatever needs to be accomplished. We have our costume moms, Gloria, Holly, and Felicia, who spent many hours making sure our costumes look great. When we need to move sets or costumes, like for a performance such as this, David is there with his truck. Teresa and Chuck Riley headed a monumental effort to organize and reclaim our costume, wardrobe, and prop inventory for the last 50 years in our basement, and now it's fully functional. There are many, many people, and my apologies if I can't mention all of you, but your work is very much appreciated by our organization. We need your help, and so if you can take time out of your busy lives to give us some assistance, that would be wonderful. We are a small yet vibrant arts community. We need to continue that support and help out each other. You saw a small example of that collaboration here today. I'd like to thank Liz Rubino and Liz Rubino Studios for their association through the year that we've been able to forge, and it is our plan to continue and expand that relationship next year. Seasonal performances, educational activities, and of course, a steadfast commitment to quality dance education have been the hallmark of Ballet Western Reserve for the past 50 years. And with this, it is the guide to our core mission into the future. It is always a pleasure to perform at Powers Auditorium for the Nutcracker, and I am pleased that we are back here in Liberty High School with a proper dance stage, changing areas, and wing space. I'd like to thank our sponsors along with all our patrons, and also I'd like to thank our parents and volunteers, and our Board of Trustees. President Sabrina Shapiro, who shares in my vision of this organization, Vice President Tricia Perry, Tom Petrie, Treasurer, Michelle Luther, Secretary. Our administration, Sharon Klein, our security and building maintenance, Alex Rubino, our noble knight, and most importantly, the faculty who have taught your children to dance and provided them with inspiration. Lee Betzel, Jackie Cunningham, Elena Svetkovich, Caitlin Doran, and Emily Pasquale, Haley Platt, Sarah Tolecki, Rebecca Van Voris, and I thank them very much for all of that work that you see on the stage today. But it also takes a team to efficiently and effectively have the foundation for Ballet Western Reserve. And that is our ballet mistress, Elena Svetkovich, and Haley Platt, our school director, who has taken on the role of making sure our school and our daily school programs run smoothly with excitement and innovation. As your artistic director, it is my pleasure working with these dancers, and it is my hope that our relationship and connection will continue into the future. Regardless of what one pursues, whether it's pursuing dance professionally or not, dance provides a discipline that can be applied to whatever profession one endeavors. Those of us who have pursued a career in dance did that with a passion and a love of dance. I'm pleased we were able to bring that passion into your home. Ballet Western Reserve, inspiration, professionalism, and dance education.
Ha ha ha! Oh.